In this tutorial, I will demonstrate how to use GeoHECRAS to automate the process of computing floodplain encroachments using HECRAS. Now here I have a HECRAS model. Let's start by checking the steady flow data. From the input ribbon, select steady flow data. It will display the steady flow data dialog box. Now from this dialog box, we are going to define the 100-year flow discharge data. The first profile listed is going to be the base profile. This profile will not be encroached and will represent the natural conditions of the river. Any additional profiles that we define will be used to compute floodplain encroachments and will be compared against the base profile computed results. Now let's define three additional profiles for specifying the floodplain encroachments. We will use encroachment method 4 for defining floodplain encroachments. This method causes HECRAS to try to match the specified increase in water surface elevation by encroaching on both sides of the floodplain overbank area. From within the dialog box, I will define the additional profiles as target number 1, then target number 2, and finally target number 3. Now if you want, you can have more target profiles. However, usually 3 target profiles are all you want while iterating the floodplain encroachment computations along the river reach. For the downstream boundary condition, we will use the water surface elevation option. This allows us to tie the downstream end of the floodplain encroachment project to an existing FEMA map. We can see that the unencroached floodplain water surface elevation is 209.5. Therefore, we will set the computed floodway elevation to be 1 foot higher than that. So I'm going to enter 210.5. And to save time, I'm going to copy that value into the remaining floodway profiles. Now, depending on where your project is located, you might have a more restrictive allowable floodway rise. For example, in the state of New Jersey, the allowable floodway rise is 0.2 feet. And in some locations, there is no rise allowed. But for a majority of the United States, a 1 foot floodway rise is allowed. Now, as we discussed, the defined base profile computed results will be compared with the 3 encroachment targets that we have defined using encroachment method 4. With these 3 encroachment targets defined, we can see which target comes closest to the 1 foot allowable rise. Now let's move over to the flow data tab. We need to make certain that the same flow discharge is defined for each profile. I will press Ctrl-C to copy the already defined 100-year base profile flow value, and then press Ctrl-V to paste this same flow value into the remaining profile rows. Now that we have finished defining the steady flow data, click the OK button. From the ribbon menu, select Analysis, and then select Floodplain Encroachments. It will display the Floodplain Encroachments dialog box. From this displayed dialog box, we will perform the floodplain encroachment analysis. The bottom portion of this dialog box is used to help us in deciding if we have reached the encroachment target or if we have exceeded it. For example, we see the 1 foot value defined for the allowable water surface elevation rise. Therefore, if the floodplain encroachment exceeds this value, the software will color the corresponding cells in red to reflect this. Also, when performing a floodplain encroachment study, we need to keep the flow velocities down. If the floodplain encroachment creates too high of a flow velocity, this will increase the flood hazard and FEMA will not approve the defined floodway encroachment. If we click on the Settings button, the Floodway Map Settings dialog box is displayed. From here, we can control how the software will plot the computed floodplain and floodway on the map view after computing the floodplain encroachments. Once we are finished with this lower section, we can click on the Collapse Section button and it will shrink the dialog box. The upper portion of this dialog box shows a table that lists all of the cross sections. The topmost row shows cross section 5. This is the downstream most cross section in the HECRAS model. We can see all 4 profiles listed in the table, with the base profile and the 3 encroachment target profiles. You can see that the base profile does not allow an encroachment method to be defined for it. That's because the software is going to use this base profile to compare with the other encroachment profiles. In the group assignment section of the dialog box, we will define the method 4 target for each of the encroachment profiles. HECRAS will not provide an exact water surface rise with what was requested when using encroachment method 4. For example, if we specify a target rise of 1 foot, HECRAS may come back with something higher or lower than that. This is because the HECRAS computational method for determining encroachment stations is only approximate. So instead of asking for just one target rise, we will use 3 encroachment targets and bracket the allowable rise. So, for the encroachment target 1, I'm going to ask for 8/10 of a foot rise. Then, click on the Assign button, and the software will assign that rise to all of the listed cross-sections. Notice at the bridged cross-section, there is no encroachment defined. That's because FEMA does not allow encroachments at a bridge opening. The bridge is already encroaching on the floodplain due to the bridge embankments. For encroachment target number 2, I will ask for a 1 foot rise, and then click on Assign. For encroachment target number 3, I will ask for a 1.2 foot rise. Hopefully, I have adequately bracketed the allowable rise and find the computed results come close to the 1 foot allowable rise. Next, click on the Analyze button, and it runs the HECRAS encroachment analysis. It then displays the computed results within the dialog box table. Also, you can see the computed floodplain and floodway plotted on the map view. In this table, we can see the water surface elevation change, the top width of the encroached water surface, the flow velocity, and the Froude number for each of the computed floodplain encroachment profiles. The Froude number indicates whether we are getting close to critical depth or supercritical flow. If the Froude number gets close to or exceeds a value of 1, then HECRAS is encroaching on the floodplain too hard, and the flow is becoming supercritical. FEMA will not approve a floodway where the unencroached profile changes from subcritical to supercritical flow. Also, when a river is squeezed that hard, the flow velocities go up quite a bit, and we don't want that. Therefore, we need to watch this Froude number value. Looking at cross-section 2 and further upstream, we see that we have exceeded the 1 foot allowable rise. So we can conclude that at the downstream end of the river reach, HECRAS is squeezing too hard. It's creating too much backwater. Also, an important aspect in floodplain encroachment modeling is to maintain a fairly uniform top width for the computed floodway. So sometimes the computed floodway top width is what controls the floodplain encroachment process. You do not want to just focus on water surface rise. Now, I know from running this model previously that we need to maintain a top width of about 480 feet. And looking at the downstream cross-section, we see that HECRAS is squeezing the floodplain too much, that the computed water surface top width is much less than 480 feet. So, at the downstream-most cross-section, I'm going to take the minimum encroachment target value that we previously defined, that of 8/10 of a foot, and make that the maximum value in the table. I can copy this value by pressing Ctrl-C, and then paste this value by pressing Ctrl-V. I will then define a new minimum encroachment target of, let's say, 2/10 of a foot. I will then split the difference between the minimum and maximum targets by entering 4/10. Click on Analyze, and it runs the HECRAS encroachment analysis. We can see that we're getting close to what we're wanting. A floodway width of 480 feet is somewhere between these two lowest encroachment targets of 0.2 and 0.4. So let's take the 0.4 value and copy that. We will make that our new maximum encroachment value. We will again split the difference. Let's enter 0.3. Click on Analyze, and it again reruns the HECRAS encroachment analysis. We see that the 3/10 target gives us a floodway top width very close to the 480 feet we are trying to match. So let's leave that value. I am going to take this 3/10 target value and copy it to the other encroachment targets for this cross-section. We are now done with this cross-section. I'm going to lock this cross-section so that I don't accidentally change an encroachment value at this cross-section later on. Click on Analyze, and it reruns the HECRAS encroachment simulation. We can confirm that all of the computed values match. Now, we're going to move to the next upstream cross-section. We can see for the second cross-section that for encroachment target 1, we have an encroachment top width of almost exactly 480 feet, which is exactly what we are wanting. So let's copy this 8/10 target value and paste it into the other encroachment targets for this cross-section. Let's lock this cross-section and reanalyze it. And let's look at the next upstream cross-section. We can see that we are really close with a target of 0.8 of a foot. So let's just use this target value for the other encroachment targets in this cross-section. Continue on up the river to complete the encroachment method 4 process at all the remaining cross-sections. As the floodway encroachments are computed, the software also plots the floodplain and floodway results on the map view. We can see the plotted floodway at the 3 downstream cross-sections. After completing encroachment method 4 for the entire river, the next step in the floodplain encroachment process is to switch to encroachment method 1. We will save our encroachment method 4 as a separate plan so that we can refer to it later during the FEMA submittal. We can then make a copy of this plan prior to performing the encroachment method 1 analysis. You can save, copy, and manage plans using the scenario manager, which is provided in the input ribbon menu. There is also a separate tutorial on how to save and copy plans using the scenario manager, so I'm not going to go into depth with that. Now, to switch to encroachment method 1, we're going to start by unlocking the downstream cross-section in the table listing. Then, in the encroachment method drop-down combo box, choose the copy 4 to 1 option. This will copy the computed method 4 encroachment stations to method 1 input data. When selecting this option, the software will display a dialog box asking what it should do. Let's select the bottommost option, which will copy the encroachment stations to all the cross-sections for all profiles, including those cross-sections that are locked. Click on the Yes button. The software will now copy the computed Method 4 encroachment stations to encroachment Method 1. You can see the left and right encroachment stations that were calculated using encroachment Method 4. Looking at our map view, we see this is the downstream most cross-section. We see that the computed left encroachment station, looking in the downstream direction, is directly adjacent to the left bank. We may want to place the final left encroachment station a little bit further outward from the left bank into the overbank area. So, from the floodplain encroachments dialog box, click on the Pick Station button next to the left encroachment station value. The dialog box will disappear, and the software will center the cross-section in the view. We can use the mouse to zoom and pan, and then click on the cross-section to place the left encroachment station a bit further outward from the left bank. Now you see the selected station value posted in the left encroachment station field. Next, we're going to revise the right encroachment station location. Click on the Pick Station button next to the right encroachment station value. From the map view, click on the cross-section to place the right encroachment station inwards towards the right bank. You see the selected station value posted in the right encroachment station field. Next, click on the Analyze button. Notice the change in the computed floodway on the map view. You'll want to similarly review and revise the floodway stations at each cross-section using Method 1. Now that the floodway has been updated, we might want to refine the computed floodway to make it look more natural. FEMA wants the final floodway to represent the natural flow of water from cross-section to cross-section. They do not want sharp bends in the plotted floodway. So let's expand the lower section of the floodplain encroachments dialog box. Click on the Settings button. From the displayed dialog box, click on the Floodway Extents tab. Next, select Interpolate Line Between Cross-Sections option. Click OK. We can collapse the lower section of the floodplain encroachments dialog box again, and then click on the Analyze button. See how the computed floodway is smoothed, making it look more natural? However, you may need to manually adjust the drawn floodway. So this is the process to compute a floodplain encroachment using HECRAS and GeoHECRAS. Now this process is semi-automated, which speeds up performing FEMA floodplain encroachment studies. Now, I hope this tutorial helps you get started in performing floodplain encroachment studies.